Hi everyone, my name is Daniel Laskowitz, and today I'll record a little video about the recent announcement that Microsoft Power Automate actually put on their blog today. It's the first day of build, and Microsoft already placed a couple of announcements on their website. One of them is the announcement that Microsoft is acquiring Softomotive, which is a company that is active in the RPA, or robotic process automation space. They acquired that company, and that's why they now have the Win Automation software available for their subscribers. So everybody who has a Flow license with RPA can use that program from now on. So if you look at the blog post, you can see that Charles Lamanna, the big boss of the Power Platform, wrote a blog post, and you can see a couple of thoughts he had. So he is talking about what possibilities that opens for customers. So he's talking about that Win Automation is really a cool tool, and you can use the UI automation in there to make sure that you can run your RPA scripts on various systems. So on SAP, legacy terminal screens, Java, Citrix, for instance, and a lot more. And that is really cool. There's also a thing about parallel execution and multitasking. So it's possible to run multiple RPA scripts at the same time. And that's really cool. So you can now execute multiple workflows at the same time. And on the same machine as well, and that's really cool. And there's also multiple additional features that are available in there, because of course Win Automation exists for a long time, and that's why they have lots and lots of features available. If you scroll down in the blog post a little bit, you can already get started with Win Automation today. So if you really want to try it out, just like me, you can go to the documentation, and I already opened the documentation, and in that documentation you learn more about how you can get started with the Win Automation tool. So there's a little bit of an overview for the existing UIflow users, so you can work on that. You can of course download the tool, you can install the tool, sign into the tool, to use your own credentials. So you need to use your own Azure AD credentials, the account where you log in to Power Automate with. And after that, you can of course set up Win Automation. You can, after you install it, you can of course open the app. You can sign in, and when you have signed in, you either get a message, just like me. I got a message like this. So there wasn't an active Power Automate license available on my account. So I needed to add that license to my account. And then I actually deleted a file. And that's also in the troubleshooting part of this documentation. But I had to delete a file, and then I could sign in again. And then it picked it up. And after that, I had to accept the permissions, of course. And after that, I could open the application. So a little bit about the error I got, because I think that some of you might encounter it as well. You can go to the troubleshooting part with the licensing issues. And if you select that, you can see that there is a way to reset the license information. So what you need to do then is you need to go to this file, or you need to delete this file. So you need to go to the Windows, the file explorer, and then you need to copy this, go there, and then delete the file msalcache.bin3. And that makes it possible for you to actually go into Win Automation again. And then it will check your licensing again. And then if it checked your license and everything is all right, you get another screen. And that other screen is what I already have available here. So you can see that the first thing you need to do after you have logged in is set a Win Automation master key. And a master key is available for encryption. So if I would, for instance, write a master key and I click OK, it will already open again the sign in to my account. I can select it and it will automatically log in to my account. And then from this moment on, I can just create a new process and start working from there. But that's something I'm gonna save for a later video. Make sure you you try this also out on your machine. I'm really looking forward to checking out what this tool can do. But this was the first video of a multiple video series, because I'm gonna show a lot more about Win Automation here. So with that, this is the end of this video. Make sure to like and subscribe. And please, if you have some questions, if you have something you wanna see in Win Automation, please leave a comment as well down here, and I'll make sure to come back to you.